How to set up ComfyUI on RunPod. Alright, here we go. It's about time I explain you guys how to run your ComfyUI on a cloud service. I'm personally using RunPod and I can only recommend them. So, it's a great tool to use if you do not have a powerful GPU. I, for example, only have a 2070 Super, and yeah, sometimes I just need more. While my computer's still good enough for the initial image generation, it lacks the power to actually run bigger workflows. I've been recently transitioning from online image generators to ComfyUI, because I just feel it suits my needs a little bit better, and, yeah, I get things done the way I want to. But that's enough for me rambling. Let's dive right in. So you go to runpod.io, for example. You can, of course, use other providers as well, but for this video, I will just go ahead with RunPod. So you just have to sign up. I've done the process already, so what you see is my dashboard right here. First thing you do, you would create a volume. Choose a location. For example, if you're sitting in Europe, choose one that has the graphics card that you want. It is quite important to choose storage because that saves your data, and you don't have to re-download all those big models and other big files again and again. So I do recommend to get the storage here. As you can see, Europe R01 does have the RTX 4090, which is the one I'm usually using for my batch generations. I get into the actual generation a little bit later when I explain my workflow, but this is basically a quick tutorial on how to set up RunPod. Let's set up our storage. For the volume name, let's say ComfyUI Test. Okay, and let's start with 100 GB first. One important thing to note here is that if you do the storage, you can always upgrade, but not downgrade. So as you can see here, at one point I actually went for a terabyte, but it was definitely much more than I needed. So I had to basically delete it all and do it again. So I recommend 100 for starters, and then as your need becomes bigger and bigger, just upgrade in maybe 50 gigabyte increments to not overwhelm you with costs. You can see the basic cost indications right down here. So if you run 100 gigabyte storage space, that will cost you about $7 per month. Okay? Let's go ahead and create. And you can see here the test one is done. All right? All what you do, you come back to home or land on this page, okay? And then instead of going to a pod and run it directly, whoops, I should be probably terminating this one. So you basically could directly deploy here, but then it doesn't feed from your storage. So you go on the left-hand side to click storage, where we just have set up ComfyUI test, and we deploy accordingly. Depending on the region that we had here, we click on the graphics card that we want. And for me, I run this configuration, or this template rather. What would you do here if you don't have that? In the search bar, you would look for ComfyUI, and look for the version that is Python 3.11 and PyTorch 2.4.0. So that's the template I'm using. I'm saying Python 3.11 is important here because certain nodes that I'm running in different workflows do require this and have trouble or causes an error if you don't run this version. So far this version I don't have any issues with all my workflows, so I'm quite happy with that. Once it's done, you click on Deploy on Demand. Now, if it's your first time setting up, this will take a while, because it will have to install all the ComfyUI relevant files to your folders. This process can take about 10 to 15 minutes, so give it some time. Everything there is done automatically. Once this is done, click the Connect button to proceed. You can see here, as I just created a new drive or new disk space rather, you need to run through this installation here. I will skip forward until this is done and talk to you in a moment. My bad. Actually, make sure that you have the play button enabled up there. So it basically runs you through the entire log. Yeah, you can see here, it started here when we first left off, and it's downloading all the, necessary files. Again, took about 10 to 15 minutes. Yeah, we're back here again, and eventually, it will say start script finished, pod is ready to use. Very good. So what we do now is we go to our pods, yeah, like we did before, and you can see this one is running, and we hit connect, and first of all, we have to go to Jupyter Lab. Wait until that terminal is loaded up. It takes a little while. Also doesn't help that I'm here in Asia and run my server in Europe. So if you're based in Europe or America, I think, if you choose a disk space in your region, then it's going to be much quicker. Anyways, we go into the terminal and we run the following scripts. Actually, it's right here on the left-hand side. We just need to start this rungpu.sh file. And we do this by typing /rungpu.sh, and this will start up our server. No, this will set up our pod, how they call it. And it's basically where we will now enable the use of ComfyUI. Again, this takes a bit of something to note here, quite important. You can see here that there's an upgrade of pip, and we just have to type basically pip install, upgrade pip. I'm doing this right now. I should have done this before I start the server, but it's fine. So go to new terminal, just copy-paste what was said earlier. Just run it. Done. Basically, we have now installed the pip upgrade. Going back to the other terminal, to our server terminal. Sorry, I keep referring to it as server. I mean our pod. We're starting up our pod, and you can see the information that we had selected earlier. It shows us a 24GB of VRAM and total, RAM of 128GB. We are running a GeForce 4090. Yeah, this is the first step of setting up your RunPod. Let us run through here real quick. And once we are actually at the stage where it says fetch comfy registry data and so on so forth, here, these lines, we can actually go back to our My RunPod window, and you can see the HTTP service is now ready. We click on that, and that should be loading up our ComfyUI page. Feel free to read through all this. I have nothing to explain here. These are basically some examples, some workflow, how you do image generation, image to image, and so on so forth. But I'm diving right in here. First of all, thing I'm doing is I'm putting the run button up here. For me, it's just more convenient. It can say run or queue. Actually, yesterday I used it, it was still saying queue. I'm a little bit confused. But if you want to run the workflow, basically you do this here. Going back really quick to my pod, you can see your utilization. So the initial installation of ComfyUI and its basic stuff actually has taken about 8% of our volume. You can see 8% here, roughly, I don't know, 8GB something. And currently, as we are not using any image generation tools or the GPU at all, you can see the GPU utilization is at 0. GPU memory is also very low at 2%, and the overall memory at 1%. We can see at the top we have basically 40GB of disk space at 100GB of network volume. You can double-check all the information here. Is everything correct? Yes, we have the 4090 running at the moment, and 2.40 PyTorch plus the Python 3.11. Looks good to me. So this is the first step of setting up RunPod. In the meantime, we can also check here the first terminal, and it says here at the end that what we're looking forward is all startup tasks has been completed. Next up, I will talk about how to set up your ComfyUI, like download all the required models, nodes, and where to get workflows from. The last part of this video will be a workflow that I have put together, but more details about that later. See you in a moment.